This video is on how you can calculate load distance, and well, this is just basically a calculation that is done by managers who are planning to determine where best to locate their plant. So there are certain techniques that are followed, when calculating this load distance. Well, there's this particular model, or should I say formula of some sort, that we need to know, which will be applying in a given example that I will share very soon. So you get to say absolute, that's what those lines mean, that's absolute. YA YB, I'll explain what these mean. So these are just about absolute values, if you still recall this from your mathematical analysis. So imagine you've been given coordinates, because so you'll be given certain coordinates of where a location might be, and then you'll be finding the absolute distance. Okay, so suppose we have what? Okay, given this, maybe 2.5. Okay, and then you would have this is maybe a certain given location, right? Like location A is 2.5. And then maybe location what? B is 3.4. Something just like that. Well, and then you would be told that, okay, maybe they want to position a certain plant, right, at maybe, let's say, location C. Just an example, I've been putting it on top because it's separate from this. Maybe they say, okay, I want to position this particular plant C at point C, which will have certain coordinates of this sort. So let me just put that for you. So then now you would start finding the distance that this particular plant C will be what? Having to cover if they locate themselves at point what? Point C. And then they tell you their supply market, of course, is the coverage of also point A and what? Point B. So now you're looking at your points, yes, have been separated. It's C is where you want to locate, and then your market or your coverage, you have to supply some A, you have to supply some B. So you're now trying to gauge the load distance as you'll be supplying to those particular points. So this is how it goes. Look at the main location C, right? It has got coordinates 8.3. Well, the way we would picture this and how it relates to our formula that you're seeing here on the screen, well, that first digit, it's like x comma y. There you know your x y planar. The first digit is x, the second digit is y. And then now, what do they mean by x a, x b? Okay, well, this x a is simply the x value from the location that you want to position yourself at, which is point C. That is where we'll get our x a from. And we said x is the first digit, of course, in our coordinates. And having known that that's the one we are using in this case as positioning ourselves, so therefore our x a here in this case will be what? It will be 8. I hope we're moving together there. So our xa will be 8. What about our xb? Which one will adopt the xb? Well, xb is just, you know, when you're subtracting with calculating the distances of where you're going, like from point C to A, right? So like go to A, for example, you want to supply to A. What are the coordinates of A? 2.5, right? Equally, it's the same model, x, y. Then since you're trying to, you're moving from what? C to A, right? So what's going to happen is that your x value will be equal to here xb. So that will be your xb, okay? Because it's the one that when you're moving from a standpoint where you're being positioned, that's your point C, and you want to see the distance that it will be taking, okay, from supplying its point A, which has coordinates of 2.5. You'll be wanting to calculate, okay, the x minus xa, and then you just have to know which one will be your xa and which one will be your xb. And I said xa is the one that we get from the particular location I want to position ourselves, which is the 8 there. Okay, that's that what we take as our xa. Then the xb is when we're now calculating, okay, from that xa going to, let's say, coordinate a, right? So point A. So point A there gets to have 2.5, and we said the x value in point A will be your xb, because you'll be using that to calculate the distance from point C to A. Okay, so just adopt that model, and then the y in the area where you want to locate, which is point C, right? your YA, right, is going to be 3. So what you just have to know is that the ones that adopt the A later, okay, those are the ones that are from where you are positioning yourself. Please take note of that. Then the B is just those that will be adopting the B later. It's just those where, like, the points where you'll be supplying to. Okay, yeah. So even for location B, we'll do a similar thing. Okay, but just know that the ones that adopt later A, it's the where you are positioned first, and then others that will adopt the other later is where you'll be targeting your markets to. Okay, so that one would be why B in this case, also point A's coordinate of Y will become a YB, which is 5. And then you just start talking X minus what? XA minus XB. So XA is 8. XB is what? 2. You find the absolute of 6, right? Sorry, yeah, the absolute of 6, it's 6. Because what does absolute just mean? Well, absolute just simply means this. Well, it just means, okay, you have absolute of that, right? It just simply means the distance that a number is away from what? From 0. So you can just count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose you have just a number line, okay. So that's the distance that a number is away from 0. Okay, how about the other one? YB, YA minus YB. YA was 3. If you rewind this video, YB was 5. Okay, 3 minus 5. Answer. 2, absolute of, sorry, negative 2. Let me just even write this, negative 2. What does the absolute of negative 2 mean? Well, okay, it just shows you that you should be at the left-hand side of your number line, okay? But what do absolute values measure? Just the distance that a number is away from 0. So these are always positive, just a distance. So if you look at negative 2, it's just 2 steps away from 0. And that's what you just say, the absolute of negative 2 is... it's always positive 2, and that's what we'll get, the positive. When you get the positives, because absolute distances are maintained in the positive version. Okay, basically that's that. Even for Y, it's the same story, right? Remember those same coordinates. We had YA, okay, as we were saying, subtracting, as well as for Y, right? Yeah, 3 minus 5. So even though you get a negative absolute, just remember your knowledge, even though your absolute is a negative figure, Just picture the number line. Okay, quite right, it's at the negative side. But what is absolute? What are absolute values measuring? Just the distance that the number is away from 0. And we get a positive distance. That's all. So let's actually look at a question after understanding that particular model. So you would have your x part subtracted like the way we did, right? We got a 6 when we subtracted xa minus x, right? What is 6? Then there was a plus, right? Then there was YA minus YB, which gave us, okay, negative 2. But we found we are looking for the absolute of negative 2, which is 2. Therefore, our distance was what? 8. That's how you'll be recording, okay? Yeah, so basically, that's what we'll be doing in all the examples. In the example that I'm actually about to share. And then we get to even appreciate this part. So we have that question. Suppose you want to locate your plant at a point A with the given coordinates of 5,4 and at point D with the given coordinates of 8,6. Given the following, okay, table, right? Yeah, you have those given what they call the census tract, or those are just given points that you can be supplying, or the distances of the particular places that you'll be taking your... maybe or whatever you're producing, okay? So you have point A, B, C, and D. But you want to specifically locate where? At A and at B. You want to have like two branches if you want to understand this. Point A and point B. Given those coordinates. And then, okay, there are populations, which we have to understand. The population is just actually viewed as a weight. I'm going to actually explain that part. So first of all, you would want to know the distance, first of all. Yeah, you want to know the distance that it will be taking you to move from all those given points, given knowing that you'll be located at A and that you supply to people who are around that given area, A to D. Okay, so we'll share next screen where we'll start now actually solving this. What you're seeing on the screen is like a draft of the table that you need to create. Okay. Yeah, you have the first column there where you put the locations where you'll be taking A to D, x comma y there is just standing for the coordinates of those particular areas. The d there stands for distance. How do you calculate distance? The one we're saying, we said the absolute of xa minus xb and the like. That's basically your formula for distance. We'll go through that again. Then LD is the load distance. Load distance is just basically a multiplication of that distance, once you get it, times the population, which was shared earlier on in the question. So that's how you'll be getting the load distance. Then what's the whole point of doing this? Well, they want to place their plant on locations A and what D. It's like possible places they want to put their plant. Then they'll gauge which one to go for based on the one that gives them the least load distance. That's why we need that column called LD, which is the load distance here. So how many locations are there? Two, right? So for one location, it's like you have this particular table, right? Let's just say these columns we've created are for testing out for, maybe placing it at location A, right? Then we will repeat the same columns and say this other side we want to try for location D. So then you compare easily. So you can say again the same column for coordinates. You have a column for distance and you have a column for LD, which is the load distance. Same thing. So you test out, we said these first three columns, you can assign them to testing for location A, okay, and getting the values for location A. And then this other side for location D. So it's, you only create these columns for the possible locations that you as a business want to assign to. So let us try and compute that and get to put those distances, okay, and the like, as we've just stated earlier on. Okay, so just erase that so that we can clean this table. So let's start with A first. What were the coordinates? 5, 4. So just putting the coordinates as they were in the question. B was 5, 3. C was 2, 4. And D, 8, 6. 8, 6. So you have your 8 there, 6. Then how do you get distance? Do you recall? We said it's that absolute A. Is it minus? Yes. XB absolute plus YA minus YB. That's your formula. Just these two, computing this, everything that gives you the distance, okay, for that particular location. Each location will be doing this. So it's just a matter of knowing XA, which one will be your XA, which one will be your XB. So picture these, copy them down. I want to just erase the screen and demonstrate like which one will be your XA and your XB, right? So you have those particular, okay, this is, I've just separated these. This is your location. You want to test out A. If A will have the least load distance. Now, you would say, how come A and A, they're having the same? Like, how do I know which one is my XA and which one is my XB? Because as we stated earlier on, we said this is X, Y. Picture that as X, Y. So we said that. Then from there, you'll be knowing which one to assign as XA and XB. That's all. So apparently the first scenarios, they are like, they are A and A. It's just that you're testing. Remember, if you position at A, right, what would be the distance there? Apparently it would be the same, because at A it's a possible place I've been looking at, and you equally have to just test it out, right? So we said the area that you're trying to, okay, that you're trying to locate yourself at, the X coordinate there we always assign an A, so that I said. And then the Y coordinate, we said we assign what? An A as well. Just so you just remember that location you're trying to assign yourselves at, or position, we assign that A there. And then those that you're now trying to test out, those distances, the places that will be giving you those distances, you'll be putting them with a B, letter B, on their X, Y coordinate. So that will be your B for that particular scenario when testing out a position, a distance there. Even when you try to go to B, it will be that. You see the same thing, and Y, B. And we'll do the same thing for point C as well, okay? Yeah, so you want to locate at A, meaning we said XA minus XB, right? Absolute plus YA minus YB, absolute. Then you start substituting. A is the point. It's your focus, your pinpoint focus, but still test it out amongst those A to D points that were given in the question. That's just the rule. So you start, okay, XA minus that. What was XA there? There was 5, minus 5. So usually one thing you'll notice that if you're trying to test out with a point that you are actually desiring to, you will be getting a zero as a distance, because there will be no need of movement. If you position at that particular point, you'll be just within the local territory. That's how it is. So if you are positioning, okay, like you want to position at A, and those possible points are A to D, right? Then at A, it's automatically the distance will be zero, so you just be remembering. Or at that particular letter, that's matching with what you want to your position. So just like when we come and test out location D, okay? Location D will just give us zero when we try to check the load distance. When we try to compute the distance going to D, to just give us zero. Because when you position at that particular point, it just gives you zero. Okay, then other points you'll be getting different values. So let's just prove that for sure you get your zero, then plus 4 minus 4. Then you can compute this 0 plus 0, answer 0. Try for B, point B. Point B, we had, these were the coordinates, 5, 3. Okay, and then of course this is your major point, your location point, which we said we are supposed to test with all those routes A to D. So we're now on trying out B now. So the distance for A was zero. As I said, if you are positioned at that particular point, it's usually zero. Then B, let's see what answer we'll get. As usual, we always assign A to those particular places, that the place that you want to locate. Okay, then the others that you're now testing out the distance for, assign them with B. Like that. So start testing out again your formula. So xa minus xb. So it will be like 5 minus 5. Okay. This one gives us 0. Plus the ya minus yb. This is ya, sorry, on top. Ya. Ya minus yb. That's like 4 minus 3. Answer. I'm getting 1. Therefore, the distance for b is 1. Okay. You get your figure there. Just like that, you'll be recording, and I'll show you a screen of now how everything will be done. Go to point C, the same story. See what are the coordinates at point C, going to C, 2, 4. A is your main target. Start testing out how the distance would be to go to C. So you'll be like, okay, XA, as usual, just remember that, XA, YA, XB, YB. And then you start doing the same thing. 5xa minus xb, 5 minus 2, absolute, plus that 4 minus 4, that's 0 the other side. Therefore, we have 3 plus 0, answer is 3. That's your distance going to point C. How about the final one, a to d, the same thing, huh? Okay, let's do that, a to d. So this is just a demonstration of how you'll be doing it when you start testing out, is it location D? Same thing. So location D had some coordinates of 8 and 6. What would be the distances if we assign B there? Okay. So here we're just trying out A first. Okay. As we're trying out this location A, we have told you that test out all the routes of moving from A to A, A to B, A to C, A to D. That's the whole point. Just do that. Then once we are done, okay, then we'll come and compare also with the figures that D will be given as well. So start again. XA minus XB, 5 minus 8. That's negative 3, absolute, plus 4 minus 6. That's YA minus YB. Just please, that's YB. Just take note of that. That's your YB there. That gives you negative 2. Okay. You'll be like, will this be negatives? No. Remember absolute. What's the absolute? It's just the distance that the number is away from 0. So just picture your number line. Okay. As I said earlier on, it has given us negative 3. But what's the distance? It's 3. The distance is 3. So we are only focusing on the distance which is positive, okay? We always take the positive, and even though it gave us absolute of negative 3, what's the absolute of negative 3? It's positive 3. Plus absolute of negative 2 is equally just the, that's the opposite. It's just 2. So you remember from your absolute values, answer 5. That's the distance to D. And you do the same thing as you try out this other location. Okay, location D was the possible location, okay? You start again from A, like you test out all the routes. That's the rule. Okay, XA, as we said, always assign A to that location that you're trying to position yourself. I just remember this. Then those ones that you're now testing the distance with, okay, start giving them the other letters like XB. Okay, let's do that. So even as you move the distance to also point B, you do the same thing. Point B was 5,3. Even here you assign X what X B as you'll be testing, okay? Then here Y B. Start getting the distances. So let's start with from D to A. Okay, that's going to be X A minus X B. That's 8 minus 5 absolute. Plus 6 minus 4 absolute. Huh? Therefore, you get a 3 here, you get a 2, and the distance is 5. So that's just basically what you'll be doing, even until you reach, you test out all the points and put your distances. How do we get what they call the LD, load distance? Load distance, we said it's that distance that you get times the population, which they would say weight. Yeah, but just remember this is population that you're multiplying by population. I'll just shorten this population. Yeah. So you get that distance for each point. You've gotten the distances. Then now you're multiplying by what? The population that was on that particular location. For example, let's look at A. What did we get for A when we were testing for A? What did we get for A, right? We got, for example, 0, right? That time when we're trying to test out the distances from positioning at A, right? We got a 0 initially. If you rewind the video, then it will be 0 times what? The population at A, it's 8. You get to the table which we had. The answer, 0. So as we said, usually, if you're locating yourself at that particular point, like A to A is always 0. See, it's as good as D to D. It's 0. Because you're within that territory, that's why you get 0. Because you won't pay any cost. If you're locating an area that you want to target, then it's cheaper. Actually, in fact, so it's the distance between 0. Yeah. And you do the same thing. Yeah, A to D, if you remember, A to B, we equally did the same thing. So load distance, just remember, it's a distance times the population in that location. Let me share the screen. So practically, this was what was being talked about earlier on. Create that table, okay? Have you seen what I've done to demarcate the two sides? You're testing out two locations fairly by using the same coordinates for each possible location or a potential location that you might want to locate your plant at. Okay, so you use the same theory, you have to get your distances as I've explained, and you have to come up with such results. Then load distance, remember, load distance is the distance that you get at that point that you're going to times the population. Let's, for example, just pick any distance in our table. Let's look at the side where there is A, okay? The way I've demarcated. Let's go to the side where there is A. And that's A, open brackets, 5,4, right? Let's go to that side. And then look at the distances in that column. Let's, for example, pick point C. Point C has a distance of 3, right? But how did we land to a load of 45? Remember how we're multiplying load, huh? It's the load, it's distance times the population at that point. So let's just confirm this so that it makes sense. We have that table, the original table we started with. We picked point C just randomly. It gave us a distance of 3, right? But how did we land at a load distance of 15? Remember, it's distance. To get load distance, it's equal to distance that you found, which was 3, times the population. What's the population there? 15, right? Yeah, that's how you get your... That's how you got 45. 3 times 15 is what? 45. And that's what we're doing. The distances we found... And start multiplying them with the population. Do the same thing with the other side of the table, which was D. Trying, as we tested location D as well, it had its own distance values that came out. And we're actually finding the same load distances. Let's also do the same. Let's just pick a random point. So we are at the side where there is D, okay? Comma, that's open brackets 8,6, right? Yeah, well, the other side, because we just demarcate, because we're just testing this fairly. Then go to those distances under that particular segment of the table. We have 5, 6, 8, and 0. For example, let's pick point B. Point B has what, according to that side, what is that coordinate for D? We have 6. The distance is 6. Under B at the other side, what is D? Okay, I hope we're following that part. Then it gave us a load distance of 30. So equally, how are we getting these distances for point D, this is the load distances for point D. It was the same thing. You get the distance as well because you are testing this separately. Don't picture them as it was one and the same. We did A separately. Even D was also done separately with its own distance values. Once you get the distance values, load distance, the same principle. It's still that distance that you get times the population that was in the table. Yeah, that's how we're getting those particular figures, if anything. And then sum up your load distances, okay? Sum them up and then determine which one gives you the least load distance. We are looking for the least load distance because these are costs that you might be incurring, okay, distances when transporting things to other people in a certain location. So we want the least to minimize cost. That's the whole point. Yeah, and then we've got one side which gave us 150. So just try and confirm that as well. And then the other side gave us 190. Which location do you pick? Well, the one on the list would choose to position our plant at A, as has been stated there. That's how you'd write your answer. So basically, this is how you deal with load distance. It's just about an understanding of how you get the distance first with those absolute figures. Then trust me, it will make sense as you even actually try out. So just rewatch this video as many times as possible to get that concept.